Now, I know what you're thinking. Is that Marlon Wayans? The answer is no, it's not. Marlon Wayans doesn't do charity shows. Coming to you live from the school with no Wi-Fi, it's your boy, Tom Marsh, AKA 10K, AKA the Prince of Plainfield. But around here at school, everyone just calls me, "Do I have to email your mother?" You know, I don't even know why I bothered to record this. The reception here is so bad, I had to write these jokes on a stone tablet. And I ran out because Moses needed the rest of them to complete the Ten Commandments. The Wi-Fi was gone so long, it was like waiting for Jesus to come back. It took forever, and it's still not back. We're still waiting for Jesus and the Wi-Fi. Hopefully the Wi-Fi will get stronger and maybe this video will come out sometime next Christmas. If that's the case, then Feliz Navidad. But I'm very excited to be here. This has always been a dream of mine. But if you would have told me that my first comedy special would be at school, I would have told you you're crazier than Kanye. But it's nice to do something at school besides fall asleep with my mouth open. I tried to get Netflix down here, but nobody responded, which is surprising because Netflix will do anything at all. How many times have you been on Netflix and been like, what is this? Who gave this garbage the green light? Why am I watching this? How on God's green earth does Too Hot to Handle have 4 seasons? It's ridiculous. How? Let me tell you something. Netflix is like your mommy. They'll record anything and everything you do and show it to everyone, no matter if it's good or bad. It doesn't matter. I want to take a moment to thank the 6 people that are going to watch this when it comes out. Your support means the world to me, and I couldn't have done it without you. I didn't know if I could do this between me and you, if we're keeping it real. I can't even make my room clean, let alone a comedy special. And these jokes are soft, like Disney Junior soft. So soft that Charmin Ultra might try to sue. But it doesn't matter if this show flops or not. I already told all my lady friends that I killed it and I did a great job, so it doesn't matter. And keep in mind, this is a high school program. This isn't HBO's newest comedy special starring Cat Williams and Chris Tucker, you know? It's rated G. Special shout out to Mr. DeVito for giving me the opportunity to waste class time and hear myself talk on camera. We all know how much I love that. They say the camera adds on weight, makes you bigger. I told Mr. DeVito I need the one that adds on some height. I'm struggling, and hopefully when this comes out, I'm right about here. So we'll get that done. What about these lunch prices? What is going on at this school? The lunch prices are so expensive here. If you can't make your payments, they'll seize your house. A friend of mine bought a nugget and a fry. Now he's living at the play area at Mickey D's, watching, taking showers in the sink and eating the wrappers the Happy Meal toys come in. Sometimes I don't know if this is IHS or the IRS. I'm the first person to declare bankruptcy in the lunch line. It's ridiculous. There's no reason that in the same world where you can get endorsed by Popeyes just for standing in line, that a hot plate at high school is a small loan of $1 million. It's ridiculous. There's no reason for it. Did that make anybody else mad? I never even thought that meme was funny. I've looked stupid waiting in fast food lines my whole life. Where's my deal? Huh? Where? Where is it? Where's my gear? Where's my money? Where's my Instagram ads for everybody to see? Where is it? I want to know. How come Popeyes didn't sponsor me that time I choked on one of their biscuits, huh? What? Why? But anyways, it's crazy. It's really crazy how expensive everything is here. But one time I was in the lunch line and my card declined in front of some girls. Bad. Very bad. I had to claim identity theft right there in front of everybody. so nobody would laugh at me. Right now I'm so broke that if I got divorced tomorrow, she'd get $3 and a favor. And tomorrow's payday. So that just tells you where I'm at right now. It's not even my fault. The job markets are tough for a kid. You know, I get so disrespected, even Rodney Dangerfield would feel bad for me. I'm 17 and need 2 jobs. It's not a joke, I'm just upset. It's very sad. Sometimes I think that my life is like a spinoff of that show, Everybody Hates Chris. I call it Everybody Tolerates Tom. There's a few similarities, but mainly differences. Everybody Hates Chris was this nice family comedy that everybody enjoyed, you know, it all worked out at the end. Everyone Tolerates Tom is a horror story. It's a never-ending battle that is rough every single day. And people always ask me, hey Tom, why comedy? Why stand-up? Why not rap or basketball? Growing up, everyone wanted to either dunk like LeBron or catch like Odell. I was the only one who wanted to be as short as Kevin Hart growing up, and as you can see, it looks like I got my wish, so I'm living with that. Though, seriously, comedy is like art. It takes words and paints something beautiful to me anyways, which is ironic because I can't draw. I can't draw at all. I've tried. I'm still at stick figures, so. Comedy can also teach you life lessons if you pay attention. One, something I learned from comedy is to keep someone's wife's name out my mouth at all times. It can be a very dangerous situation if you don't do that. My favorite comedian has to be Eddie Murphy. You know, Eddie Murphy was a bad dude. He was him. Eddie Murphy was the type of guy to come in, do a show, kill it, leave with the girl you came with, and then go record Daddy Daycare, all while wearing Michael Jackson's red jumpsuit from Thriller. It's crazy. He's my inspiration, though. I even like some of his music, but I don't think music's for me. Every guy has a phase where they think that they're gonna be a music star, and it's nothing but pure delusion, but it's very real. Coming out of eighth grade, I thought that Tommy the Terror was gonna go down with the likes of some of the greatest musical artists that anybody had ever seen. Drake, Biggie, Tupac, Tommy the Terror. I wouldn't even rap about anything. I'd only talk about how difficult things were living in a two-story home where everything works and the sun is always shining, the grass is always green, and the birds are always chirping. I rapped about how hard it was being in private school all the time, being completely safe, how I had to struggle in the suburbs and always be on my toes and be aware of my surroundings. But all those hardships got me to where I am today. It made me the man I am today. But hey, at least there was Wi-Fi. Thank you, everyone who came out. Thank you, Mr. DeVito. Thank you, everyone. You can't really see him. But thank you for everyone who watched, everyone who supported me through this. I appreciate this. Special shout out to my boy, Matt. I appreciate that. He helped me a lot with this. I will be back. We'll try to get another one of these out before I'm out the door and they kick me out to college. So I just want to tell everyone I'm very thankful. And if you're watching this, thank you.
Civilized, take the one feel vilified. You can't see my sons like the.